Hello, good evening, guys. It's Friday, so at least closer to the weekend. And here we have Charlie, as always, very punctual. Hello, Charlie. Good evening.
Good evening. El 90% del éxito es llegar temprano, en mi opinión, así.
That's it. That's true. Definitely. And how are you doing? I see. And how many kids do you have?
Me?
Yep.
32
no.
years old?
No. I mean, how many kids? How many sons or daughters you have?
Only one.
Okay, only one.
Only one, she has 5 years.
She is 5 years, okay. She is in kindergarten, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I imagine, okay. Very nice. Thank you, Charlie. Maritza, good evening.
Good evening.
Hello, how was your Friday?
Oh, good. Good day. Sure. Yes. Tomorrow is Saturday. Yes.
It's Saturday good. Is better than Friday. Any
yes.
And it's better than Monday. Definitely.
Yes.
Okay, but that's good. Okay, thanks, Maritza. Andreita, good evening. The girl in white.
Hi, teacher. Good evening.
Good evening. How about your Friday? Normal, good.
Acceptable. No, very stressful day.
Stressful day. Okay, yes. Yes. Now you're going to have very hard days, right?
Yes.
From what? From this week, right? Since this week, you're having hard days. Okay. But Andrea, yes. Are you having vacations on January or something like that? Or I don't know, because December is going to be a very difficult month for you.
Is the more yeah. difficult month.
Yeah. I can imagine.
Yes. ¿Y solo nos dan vacaciones al año?
Yearly. Or once a year or yearly. Okay. So let's wait for the vacations, Andre. Okay, thanks. Elsa, hello again. I like to see you with your camera on. Hello, Elsa. Okay, I guess we're having some kind of problems.
Okay. See.
Yeah, Elsa.
Yes,
I can hear you, but the connection is not good. I guess the internet is having, well, you're having problems with the internet. We're going to wait. Vamos a esperar. Okay. Okay, fine. Today, the topic is how to use would like, would and would like. That is a very easy topic. That is for babies. But that's why I have some other topics for you to learn more and to acquire more knowledge, okay? And so here we have, this is like the first question, very simple. Have you received refunds for a product or service in your life or in your family? Okay, Susie, Q, good evening.
Good evening, teacher. Okay. How are you doing?
I'm doing okay. Today I practiced some sports. I went to this basketball field. So I feel good. I feel very good.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Really?
Yes. Okay. At least once a year. And what about you?
What's a normal day?
What's a normal day? Okay. Susie, have you received refunds? With a product or service?
No. No, for the moment, no.
Not for the moment.
Until now.
Okay. Yes, so that usually happens that no tenemos, we don't have like this kind of situation, but depends. El reembolso no siempre es válido, okay? Maybe we have to pay more when we get any product, right? We have to pay more in order that product maybe fails. We are going to have like some money or another product. Okay, Susie, thanks. What about Andrea? Any refund in your family or any products?
No.
Okay, that surely happens. Okay, what about Charlie?
Yes, that year, I received a refund in Bidri for I bought ¿cómo sería? Una bomba rociadora.
Okay. Mm-hmm. A water bomb, maybe, yes, or something like that. A spread bomb, spread bomb. Okay.
Okay, I paid for one. I realized the push and order, and when I go to retire.
Retire
the product, say me not have, and but they me ofrecieron.
They offer me.
They offer me two water bombs for same price. I cancel. Oh,
okay, for the same price. Okay.
I received two.
Yes, two. No, that was good. At the end was good. Okay, very positive. What about you, Maritza? Any refund?
Refund? Not, but...
maybe warranty. Yes?
No, but no. Change product.
Ah, change product. Okay.
Yes.
But that was good, similar to Charlie.
Discount in other factura?
Yes, bill, in another bill.
In another bill.
Okay.
But no refunds, I don't remember.
Okay. Well, they say that they have not received any refunds, but maybe discount in another bill or change the product. Okay, good.
Yes.
Okay, perfect. And what about Dianita? Are you there, Diana? Hello.
Hi, teacher. Good evening.
Evening.
No.
No refund, no warranty, no discount change product?
No.
Okay. I'm so sorry then. Well, or maybe that's positive. Thanks. Jasmine, good evening. Okay, maybe she's going to connect.
Hi, teacher.
Hello, are you okay?
Yes, I being my baby.
Okay, perfect. So tell me, have you received refunds or warranty service or discount change product?
What is the same refunds?
Refund es un reembolso.
Warranty,
garantía, discount, descuento, change product.
I don't remember.
You don't remember actually, okay.
No
problem. Let's listen to what if we listen to Elsa? Any experience with this, Elsa?
Yes, teacher. Is the same Maritza? They change the product or
that's perfect.
Tarjeta de regalo, no sé cómo se dice.
Gift card. Mm-hmm. For a gift card. Mm-hmm.
The same valor.
Well value? Same value, the same quantity of price. But that was positive, okay?
Yes,
yeah, that was good.
Very nice.
Very nice. Thanks. And what if we listen to Edgar Chacon? Are you there, Edgar?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. We are talking about refunds, warranty, discount, or change products. Have you experienced this? Have you received something like that?
Really? No.
No.
Never.
Okay. Yeah, that usually happens. Okay, and I guess we have also Helen. She is on her way, and Beatriz as well. Manuel, hello, my friend. Are you over there?
Hello.
Hello. Good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
Manuel, we're talking about refunds, warranty, and discount or change products. Have you ever experienced something like this?
No.
No. Okay.
Una.
Okay.
Siempre me han bajado.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry that is very common in our country. Yes, because the companies are focused on the sales or obtaining money but not specifically give good service or give good products. That's the reason, unfortunately. So we are customers or clients, we have like negative results. Mercy, good evening. How are you doing?
Good evening, teacher.
Everything okay, Mercy?
Good.
Okay, good. Today's Friday, remember. Yes. Happy. Yes, Mercy. Have you received refunds, warranty, discount, or change of product in any of your purchasing?
¿Cómo se dice la última vez?
The last time.
Mm-hmm. No dije nada. Como de mis zapatos grandes.
Ah, yes.
No,
but
no hice reclamo.
And maybe there was a possibility or not.
No, porque era purchase.
Ajá, purchase.
Online.
Online purchase.
Online.
Yes, that's different, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
They don't change products. Okay. Yes, I understand. Pero ahí los tenés. Okay.
Guardados.
Yes. Ahí tenés los marcados. Okay. Thank you, Mercy. I want to tell you an anecdote. At the beginning of this year, I bought this pair of headset. Look, these are Bluetooth headphones. I don't like to use them when I'm teaching the class because they have some, I don't know, the audio, it is not so good in comparison to this one that is with cable, okay? So, when I bought these earphones, the seller told me if I wanted to pay for the warranty, si quería pagar la garantía, and I say yes because it was $5. And imagine the last month my headphones broke down, se arruinaron, no sound. So I went to that store, I showed the bill, enseñé la factura, and they changed the product. So these are new because of that warranty. So I paid $5. Imagine if I didn't pay that, I wouldn't have another pair of headphones. So that's because maybe you are lucky or not. A veces la suerte del producto. Okay, so that happens. Damari, good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
Hello.
Hello. Okay? Yes, pretty good.
Pretty good. Okay. We are talking about refunds, warranty, discount, or change product. Have you experienced any of these situations? Reembolso, garantía, descuento.
No he entendido todavía. Estoy.
Ajá,
no sé
si alguna vez te han hecho reembolso, descuento por algún producto defectuoso.
No remember, teacher.
No, you don't remember. Okay, no problem. Okay, just to remind you how to use would and would like to. This is the topic of today. And here we have this phrasal verbs. What are phrasal verbs? They are used in a lot of conversations, and they are composed by a main verb. Están compuestos por un verbo. For example, get, and a preposition. Okay? That is the main. It can be a verb, and it can be an adverb. Okay? And speed up. Okay? So, these are phrasal verbs. You already know them. Ya los conocen ustedes. Por ejemplo, stand up, levántate. Sit down, siéntate. You already know phrasal verbs. Ya conocen los phrasal verbs. But as a characteristic of phrasal verbs is that they are composed by irregular verbs. O sea que todos los phrasal verbs tienen verbos irregulares. La mayoría. Hay algunos que son regulares, pero la mayoría son irregulares. Okay, so, put on, okay, and take off. You put on a shirt, and you take off a shirt, okay? Esta es la espalda, ¿verdad? Para que no piensen mal. Okay, pick up, we already know what is pick up, and drop off, okay? Pick up, es recogerle, pasar, darle raya a alguien, ir a traer a alguien. That's pick up. Drop off es ir a dejar a alguien, pero no tirarlo. You can drop off a person to the airport, to the park, or wherever. Get on, subirse. Get off, bajarse. Run after, perseguir. Run away, escapar. Okay? Speed up. Imagine Charlie with his motorcycle. Speed up. Acelera.
Teacher,
and slow down. Yes.
What mean put on and take off? Sorry.
Okay, put on es ponerse. Probarse, ponerse. Okay, ponerse una camisa. You put on some pants, a pair of pants, shoes. Okay, eso es ponerse.
Oh, okay, no, es que no distinguía bien los dibujitos.
Sí, sí, no, no, bien raro, ¿verdad? Ajá, ya les dije que esto es la espalda, ¿verdad? No vayan a pensar más porque Damaris piensa mal. I'm sorry. Yes.
Sí, no, teacher.
Yes?
No.
Teacher, run yes. After. What is the meaning?
Vaya, cuando te va siguiendo un policía, ¿verdad? Es run after, es perseguir. Y run away, escapar. Aquí está el tip.
Okay.
Ajá, aquí está el ladroncito. Okay.
Perseguir y escapar. Okay.
Yes, yes, yes. Mm-hmm. So, can you notice they are opposites? They are opposites. Okay, put on, no put on, put on, take off, pick up, como el pick up, como los carros, pick up, drop off, get on, get off, run after, run away, speed up, slow down. Sometimes a person is speaking very fast, and you can say, slow down, chill out, como dice Susie. Ah, slow down. Bájale las revoluciones, bájale la velocidad. So that's it. Okay. So let's listen to some of you. What is any phrasal verb that maybe calls your attention? We're going to start with Maritza and then Susie.
Put on.
Okay, thanks. Susie, Damari.
Run after. After.
Okay, run after. Damari, Mercy.
Put on.
Okay, Mercy, Diana.
Speak up.
Speed up.
No, pick up.
Pick up. Yo escuché speak up. Yo, okay.
Sí, creo que me confundí.
Sí, estás enamorada, up. Mercy. Okay, thank you.
Pick teacher, up. Con esa tengo una duda. Pick up, como recoger algo, pero de objeto.
No, y, a person.
No, yo pensaba, pensaba
puede
que recoger a una persona era como, no me, se me ha olvidado la frase, ¿cómo se dice recoger a una persona? Leave, no.
Sorry?
¿Cómo se dice cuando le pide a alguien que la ride. Pase recogiendo?
Give a ride, esa no es otra, dar un ride. Give a ride.
Y pick up también puede ser para varios, o sea, para objetos y para personas.
Normalmente es para personas. Creo que los demás ya hemos tenido conversaciones con pick up, ¿verdad? Sí, que yo se las he mostrado. Por ejemplo, hey, can you pick me up at the airport, please? ¿Puedes recogerme en el aeropuerto? Okay.
Lo que pasa es que le pregunto porque a veces a los niños, o sea, recoger algo, yo digo pick up, o sea,
¿también?
Pero recoger
sí,
un objeto.
También. Take, pick up, lift. Okay. Lift también es recoger. Levantar.
Ajá, lift.
Ajá, okay, pero
gracias.
You're welcome. Lift es sí, es levantar. You can lift weights. También pueden levantar pesas. You can lift objects. So lift. Pero también pick it up, ¿verdad? Porque a veces, esa es otra cosa. Los sujetos a veces van aquí, ¿ve? Pick the book up. Levanta el libro, ¿ok? A veces así pasa, pero después vamos a ver esto, ¿ok? Esto solo se los estoy presentando para que tengamos una idea. Ok, Diana and Jasmine, pick one.
Run away.
Good. Jasmine, Elsa.
Get up.
Good. Elsa, Edgar.
Slow down.
Good. Edgar, Manuel.
Slow down.
Good. Manuel, Andrea.
Get up.
Ok, Andrea, Charlie.
Take off.
Okay, Charlie, Beatriz.
On the way.
Okay, Bea, Edenilson.
Get up.
Okay, Ellen Nilsson, Helen.
Drop off.
Good. Helen.
Get up.
Okay, yes. So here we have some phrasal verbs. There are thousands of these. Hay miles de esos. But we're going to learn them little by little. Okay? Little by little.
For example, kick off is a phrasal verb.
Yes.
Kick off.
Phrasal verbs are verbs composed by two words. Son los que tienen dos, todos los que tengan dos palabras y que sean verbos, son phrasal verbs. Give up, take out, shut up, stand up, sit down. Todos esos son phrasal verbs. Okay. It's a pleasure. And now here we have this. There are positions. Kneeling. Kneeling. Cuando ustedes están pidiendo perdón. ¿Ve? Kneeling. Arrodillarse. Kneeling. Lying. Recostarse. Okay. Slouching. Encorvarse. Estar así. Okay. Sin ánimos. Crouching. Okay. Crouching es agacharse. Leaning es apoyarse, leaning. Squatting es en cuclillas. Sitting, sentarse, standing de pie. Okay, kneeling, kneeling. Lying, slouching, crouching. Leaning, squatting, sitting, standing. The most used are kneeling. Okay, kneeling, sitting, standing. Those ones, okay? So this is a part of the new vocabulary. So for you to know some of them, sometimes you say, teacher, I don't know how to say it or how do you say this? And maybe there are some opinions or anecdotes that you don't say because maybe you don't have some words. You don't have the words to express some ideas. Okay. And before this, I'm going to check the attendance list. So please say hello if you are there. Ana Mercedes, hello there.
Present.
Thank you, Andrea.
Hi.
Hello, Charlie.
Present.
Thanks. Carmen, we are not having, maybe Carmen is not going to be here. Right, Andreita? Maybe not. We don't know.
She is a party.
Oh, she's at the party. I guess she's had it.
Yes.
Today is her birthday, right?
Yes.
Yes, I saw a picture over there. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I hope she's having a good time. Carito is not here. Okay. Maritza?
Present.
No. Claudia Diaz? No. No, Claudia. Okay. Diana?
Present.
Thank you. Eden Nilsson?
I'm here.
Thanks. Edgar.
Present.
Thanks. Elsa.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Damari.
Present.
Good. Helen.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Kevin.
Present, teacher.
Thanks. Manuel.
Present.
Thank you. Marlon. No, you are tonight. Susie Q.
I'm here.
You're there. Jasmine.
Present.
And Bea. Hello, Bea.
Present.
Thanks. Okay. To continue, here we have this refund form. Es un formulario. Cuando digamos form, significa forma, pero también es un formulario. Okay, so here we have this refund form. And here we have the company, Waterlux Inc. Waterlux Inc. Here we have the sender's name and address. Okay, Waterlux Inc., Travers Inc., 23, Glenway, San Carlos. Okay, send, tell me, Beatriz, do you remember what is solo send? ¿Te recuerdas qué es send?
No sé.
Okay, no problem, relax.
Enviar,
ajá, así que sender es la persona que envía, ¿verdad?
Viene de send, enviar. Sender, sender.
Sí, es la persona que
envía. Ah, ok.
Ahora, submit también significa enviar, ¿verdad? Ajá, entonces, there are synonyms. Okay, so here have note, and I need the sexy voice of Mercy. Note, number one, please.
Okay, please note, what a looks customer satisfaction warranty,
yes,
is
90
days from day or purchase.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Mercy. So, that's a note. 90 days from the date of purchase. So imagine Diana buys something now. So today is 12, November 12th. So imagine you have to count 90 days. And after those days, the warranty is over. So that's important to take into account, especially when you buy televisions, when you buy something like that. You have a specific period of time in which you can ask for the warranty. You can ask for, I don't know, maybe devolutions, refunds, anything about it. But if your product breaks down out of this period of time, so you're going to be out. So that's the problem. Edgar, number two, retain.
Retain a copy of your records. Enclose the original with the merchandise.
Okay. Yes. That is very common that when you buy a television, for example, they say you should keep the box. Guarden la caja, guarden all the papers and all those things. So it is important to have copies of your bills and all the paper necessary. Okay. So thank you. And Maritza, number three, use on one line.
Just one line per item. All quantities are to be reported in each space. All items returned will require the original order number recorded on the form so credit can be processed.
Yes, thank you. So here we have the stock details. Stock significa existencias. Por eso que a veces dice, ah, son los que están en stock, ¿verdad? Sometimes you see ads on Facebook or internet. So they say, available in stock, ¿verdad? Que están disponibles las existencias, las que están en existencias, ¿ok? So remember, se pronuncia item, ¿verdad? Item. So here we have the reason code, item number, quantity, date of purchase, order number and relevant reason. Okay, so you can detail, pueden detallar acá el producto. So adverse event, dissatisfaction, product performance. So maybe here we have an accident, adverse event, dissatisfaction. Maybe the product was not the one that you expected, and product performance es que no funcionó bien, ¿verdad? El producto. So this is a form. Okay. So now here we have check. And for this, I will need Andrea, one or two. Select one, Andreita, and then Charlie.
What are reasons the customer wants a refund?
Okay. What are the reasons? Let's see. This is the information.
Missing parts.
Yes, missing parts. That's it. Product performance, missing parts. So the product was not complete. Very good. Ay, André. So it was. Okay, Charlie, number two. Good.
Would the customer get the refund? Why?
What do you think? Do you think the customer will get the refund?
I don't know, Tisha. I don't know.
You don't know. Okay. I guess, it is important. The date, ¿verdad? Es importante la fecha, okay? So here we have the date is 11th, okay? November 23rd, 2017. Imagine if we are in 2021, he is not going to get the refund, but maybe in the same year or in 2018, en 2018 todavía podría, remember, 90 days, okay? So that's it, but maybe in this case, it is not so clear, no está muy claro, Charlie. Aquí no está muy claro porque no está la fecha de que está presentando esto, right? So that's it. But let's imagine if he presents this in 2019, definitely not. He's not going to get it. Okay. Have you ever had accidents at home? Tell an anecdote. I know, we know that Charlie has a lot of experiences and adventures about this, but it is important to mention one. So, what if Maritza tells one anecdote about accidents at home?
Okay. I have a doll. Mm-hmm. One day when I have parked my car on the street in front of my house.
Okay.
I remember that I had forgotten a bag and I crossed the street. And the dog left behind me.
Uh-huh.
And when I returned, I didn't find it.
Yes.
Suddenly it came running behind me and a car came at high speed. The dog, excuse me?
Yes, yes.
And a car came at high speed.
High speed. Yes.
The dog did not stop and the car slowed a little, but...
Not enough.
No, but only hitting the trunk.
Uh-huh.
In the trunk. I screamed loudly.
Mm-hmm.
The dog was dumb or mm-hmm. stupid.
Yes, one dog.
Ran and disoriented, but only it had a little bruising in its nose.
Okay, but nothing worse, nada peor, no. Wow,
no.
That's good. Mm-hmm. That dog is very lucky. Que suertudo.
Yes.
Yes. So is the dog alive? ¿Todavía está vivo el perrito?
Yes. Only the noise. It noise.
The nose.
Okay. The nose.
Uh-huh. It has some injury, two heridas, or maybe some kind of blood. Uh-huh. Okay.
Yes,
oh.
But only.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that usually happens, especially out of our houses, especially with the dogs. They came after us. Okay, so well, he's very lucky, and I know that you were very scared. Estaba bien asustada, man.
Yes.
Okay. Well, that's a good anecdote because it has a happy ending. You know, final phrase. Thank you, Maritza. Very nice. Let's listen to Susie. Okay, Susie, what about you? Any accidents at home or near your house?
Only one. Okay. Once I fell in the bathroom, was very wet, and I was a little sleepy. I stood on the bathroom floor and sleep. ¿Cómo se dice en italiano? Sleep. Sleepy.
Yes. You can say slide. Slide.
Okay, mm-hmm. Slide. I hit my arm and hip. I was left with only bruise. Moretones, teacher?
Yes. You bruce. Can say, yes, bruised or black parts. Mm-hmm. Like okay. Black eyes. Mm-hmm. Okay, was it in the morning?
No, in the night.
At night, okay.
At night, sorry,
Did you hit your head or just the arm?
the arm and hit.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, but nothing worse. That was good because you didn't hit any other part of your body.
Bueno, al menos no fue tan así.
Okay. Ah, ya se andabas mareada. Yeah, okay, so no, that was not an accident. It was not an accident. Okay. Ya ves,
¿sabe,
eso sí.
¿Sabe qué es lo peor? Que, o sea, me pasan las cosas cuando ando sobria. Bueno, ahí está.
Cuando anda, bueno. No, si eso siempre es así.
Y cuando ando hasta la quita chingada, tranquila.
Nada, no pasa,
o sea,
nada.
Me va, así como que, pero nada, nada grave.
Yes, that usually happens. I don't know why. No sé cuál es la mística de eso, pero así es. Así es. Okay. Thanks, Susie. Okay. What if we'll listen to Mercy? Okay, Mercy?
Okay, teacher. I was 4 years old. I played hide and seek with my brothers.
Mm-hmm.
I went out a closet to hide. I lost my balance and fell, hitting my head on the bed. What was the result of the accident? I seen of 4 centimeters.
Centimeter
in my head.
Wow. Did you have to go to the clinic or to the doctor? No.
Sí, yes. Me llevaron al hospital y sí, pasé toda la noche ahí porque me tuvieron que raspar la parte de,
yes,
acá de la cabeza. Okay. Y sí, me tuvieron que coser.
Ok. ¿Qué cosas? Okay,
ya sí, quedaste. Cuando este lado me duele.
Really, even?
Yes.
Ok. Just, bueno, hay varias tipos de tratamiento para eso. Eso sí conoce tratamientos especiales para eso, por si tenés. So, thanks. Okay.
Only.
Okay, only that. Thank you, Mercy. What if we listen to Edgar? Are you ready, Edgar?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, go ahead, please.
I never had an accident at home.
Okay. Hello, Edgar.
No escucho.
No, again, please.
I never had an accident.
No accident. Oh, you're so lucky.
Only my mom.
And what happened to your mom? Did she fall down?
She fall down in charco, como se dice?
Yes, in the mud. Mm-hmm.
Mud, slide in the mud.
Yes, slide in the mud. Yes, that usually happens.
Y pasó como unos 3 días que le dolía donde había caído.
So sorry. Yes, when you are adult, you are older, those kind of falls and accidents are worse. Son peores. Entre más jóvenes somos, entre más niños, no problem. But now, yeah, it is worse. That is what happens. Thank you, Edgar. So I'm sorry, but that happened a long time ago or recently. Pasó hace bastante, quizás, ¿verdad? No tan reciente. Okay. Thank you, Edgar. Okay, and we're going to study this. Would and would like to. Here I have some sentences. This is very simple and easy. You have studied this before, so it's not going to be a problem. Damari, please, can you read the first two sentences?
I could change this product. He will buy there again.
Again, okay, thank you. Susie, we and would.
We wouldn't stay in this place. Would you give me your information?
Thank you. Maritza, I and he.
I would like to change this product. He would like to buy there again.
Okay, Andreita, they and would.
They wouldn't like to come back here. Would you like to get a refund?
Okay, perfect. That's it. And now here we have some sentences. Complete the following statements or questions. Son oraciones o preguntas. Charlie.
Okay, number one.
Okay.
I would like to buy a new motorcycle.
Yes, we are sure about it. You want a new motorcycle. Okay, perfect. And Susie, please pick one. And then Diana.
Perdón, teacher, ¿qué tenemos que hacer?
We have to complete it. You have to complete it the way you want it. De la manera como tú quieras, okay?
I would like to buy this refrigerator.
Yes. Refrigerators are always necessary. Necessary a lot. Okay, what if we listen to Andre, Diana, and then Elsa?
Puede ser con cualquier oración, ¿verdad?
Sí, sigue sería... tu corazón.
Number three, could she open the door?
Yeah, why not? Elsa and then Kevin. Okay, let's move to Kevin because Elsa maybe is having some difficulties. Kevin, are you there?
Hi, teacher.
Ah, okay, Elsa, please, I need you to pick one of these and complete it.
Number five,
se equivocaron, es wood. Ajá, yes. Ajá,
she wouldn't dance with me.
Okay, she would dance with me. Okay, Kevin and then Andrea.
Number six. Es word, ¿verdad?
Word, yes.
Hay que aprender esa palabra en literal.
Yes, yes.
Okay, would you like to play with me?
Yep, that's it. Con tu corazón. Okay. Andreita.
Teacher, number two. Podría ser Mr. Trujillo wouldn't have a car. Has a car.
Have. Mm-hmm. Yes, pero como que le hace falta algo. Como el señor Trujillo no tendría un carro si se portara bien, si hiciera caso, si ya. Ese se escucha como un condicional, como que no tendría un carro a menos que. Ya. Yeah.
Y para decir no tiene, Mr. Trujillo, no, no.
Doesn't have. Mm-hmm. Okay.
This topic is so complicated.
You think so? Really?
Quizás no, pero que... lo que acaba de decir, o sea, influye mucho porque si no lleva un complemento, no sé, no tiene sentido.
Solo con el verbo have, vaya, Susi. ¿Qué otro complemento podría tener con Mr. Trujillo? Mr. Trujillo, wouldn't.
Vaya, pero wouldn't, ¿qué significa?
Ok. Would. ¿Sería?
Ah, perdón.
Casi. Would hace que todos los verbos terminen en ia, ¿verdad? I like, me gustaría, cantaría, bailaría, trabajaría, besaría, ¿ok? Ahora. Sí, le vamos a poner I wouldn't. No me gustaría, no trabajaría, ¿verdad? No besaría, no bailaría, todo eso. Ya. Yeah. Entonces, eso hace. Would es un modal verb. Es un verbo modal. No necesariamente tiene un, ¿cómo se llama? Un, vaya, es como cuando hacemos esta pregunta, mira. Do. ¿Qué significado tiene do?
Es solo para preguntas. Uh-huh, y pero, yo lo que veo es que te gusta la pizza o te gusta.
Exacto, ¿no? Exacto. Uh-huh. Pero do no tiene un significado literal ahí. Solo está para ayudarnos a hacer la pregunta. Ah, entonces así es con would. No es que tenga un significado literal, sino que modifica el verbo y hace que todos los verbos terminen en ia.
O sea que depende del verbo el significado de la oración.
Exactamente. Vamos a poner un ejemplo. Vaya. Dígame un verbo en español, verbo de acción. Andrea, dime un verbo.
Caminar.
Caminar. ¿Con ia cómo sería? ¿Cómo sería?
¿Caminaría?
Uh-huh. Sí, decimos un verbo.
¿Saltar?
Sería, ¿con would?
¿Saltaría?
Ok. Vamos a ver, Damare, un verbo de acción. O sea, que se pueda ver.
Comer.
Ajá. ¿Con ia sería?
Comería.
Comería. Uh-huh. ¿Hoy sí, más o menos?
Entonces no. Tienen que llevar un verbo de acción. Entonces sería Mr. Trujillo wouldn't like walk.
To walk or wouldn't like hamburger. Uh-huh. No le gustaría la pizza. Mm. Ya. Yeah. Lo que normalmente se utiliza con like. Eso ténganlo por seguro. Utilicémoslo ahorita con like. Si lo utilizan con otros verbos, van a necesitar otro tipo de estructura gramática que se llama condicionales. Por eso ahorita solo estamos con like. ¿Ok? Bueno, yo creo que voy a tener...
Aunque en los ejemplos que nos presentó de primero, solo aparece would en would like. Uh-huh, uh-huh. ¿Puede ponerlos de regreso, por favor?
Sí, con solo que no me haya gustado. Ajá.
Si se porta bien.
Mira, Susi, espérate que te la tengo guardada. Espérate, después. Ok, yes. Vaya, por ejemplo, vamos a la segunda. ¿Qué dice aquí? ¿Qué te dice tu corazón, Susi?
Él compraría ahí de nuevo.
Uh-huh. Quiere decir que es una buena experiencia, ¿no? Él compraría ahí de nuevo. Ok. Ajá. Entonces, y aquí dice, he would like to buy there again. A él le gustaría comprar allí de nuevo. Ahora. Vaya,
pero, o sea, yo eso lo tengo claro. En afirmativo, en negativo creo que es el wouldn't.
Yes, vamos con el wouldn't aquí, con we.
We wouldn't está ahí. Ellos no estarían en este lugar.
No se quedarían.
No se quedarían.
Uh-huh. Digamos que te vas, you go to Esquipulas and there are some bad hotels and you say, we wouldn't stay in this place. No nos quedaríamos en este lugar.
Es que tal vez mi confusión más grande, la grande de la existencia del mundo, ¿verdad? Podría ser de que cuando ocupamos en she, he, it, casi siempre es diferente. Por ejemplo, doesn't, y o sea, quizás no tiene nada que ver ahorita, pero no se cambia con you, we, they. O sea, no se cambia, sino que para he es wouldn't también, o she wouldn't.
Uh-huh. Esmeralda. Tu interrogante es 100% aceptable. Te voy a explicar por qué. Hay algunos que se llaman modal verbs. ¿Cuáles son los modal verbs? Ustedes ya los conocen. Ya. Todos estos que son modal verbs, estos no necesitas poner el doesn't, ni que te importe si es primera, segunda, tercera persona, si es tu ex, no te importa nada, ¿ok? Con estos, sí, disfrutar, ¿verdad, Mercy? Con estos, lo que importa simplemente es que modifican el verbo. Can es poder, could, podría, should. Should significa debería, ¿verdad? You should visit your grandmother. Debería visitar a tu abuela. You should go to the doctor. Deberías ir al doctor. Pero el would afecta directamente al verbo. Y hace que todo termine en ia. ¿Ok? Entonces, when you use these modal verbs, you don't care about third person. ¿Okay? Que no les interese a las terceras personas, si este verbo coincide o no. Es como que ¿sí? Se puede utilizar porque son verbos modales. Ya. Y siempre, 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 estos van a necesitar un verbo. Vaya. Susi, ¿me podrías hacer una oración con cualquiera de estos? Negativa, afirmativa, lo que sea.
Can you repeat me, please? Or can you repeat that, please?
Ok. Can se está utilizando. ¿Cuál es el verbo ahí? Can you?
Can you repeat?
Repeat. Ese es el verbo. Ok. Vamos a ver. Mercy. ¿Podrías hacerme una oración con cualquiera de estos?
Ok, would you call?
Could you call again, please? ¿Podría llamar de nuevo? Could you, el verbo es?
Call.
Call. Ok, Charlie, could you create or make a sentence, please? ¿Podrías hacer una oración?
Should you,
como tú quieras, should you or you should.
So you should sing a song.
Okay, that's it. Entonces, todos estos necesitan un verbo ya de acción. Entonces, en el caso de would, okay. Creo que el lunes le voy a traer más ejercicios de would, ¿verdad? Para que ya tengan como más que claro esto. ¿Le parece? Y ya,
bueno, quizás mi duda era eso por lo de las terceras personas y quizás eso, porque casi siempre se modifica. Entonces yo dije, qué
sí, raro. Y tiene lógica porque estamos en presente y por eso. Ya. Pero no, estos modal verbs, no sé si ya los anotaron, pero estos modal verbs no necesitan modificarse. Por eso me gustan bastante. Y a todos nos gustan eso. Ya. Porque no necesitan modificar nada. ¿Ok?
Gracias, don.
Vaya, Susi, ya va dos. Vaya, no permitas. Van a ser dos, Susi. Después. Mala esta mujer. Mala. Worksheet. Ok, vamos. Lo del wood. Como dice la señorita Esmeralda, lo vamos a revisar otra vez el lunes, ¿ok? Porque necesito un poquito más de práctica con algunas oraciones. Bien, ahora vamos a un tema que me gusta bastante. El past progressive con el simple past. Esta es la unión de dos pasados, pero no se refieren a situación. Bueno, sí a situaciones, pero no a personas. Tenemos el pasado simple y el pasado progresivo o el continuous. Es el que hemos estado viendo. Por ejemplo, el continue o el progressive, que es lo mismo, es este. Mira. I was watching TV. ¿Sí? I was watching TV. Es el que hemos estado practicando estos últimos días. ¿Ok? Y tenemos el pasado que es simple, que es, por ejemplo, the phone rang. El teléfono sonó. Okay. Entonces, ¿cuál es el punto acá? Cuando se unen dos oraciones, uno con el past progressive y el past simple, es que se interrumpe. Un ejemplo. Aquí dice, they were enjoying the morning. Ellos estaban disfrutando la mañana cuando el ladrón robó el maletín. Okay. Entonces, la acción que estaba pasando es que se estaban divirtiendo cuando el ladrón robó el maletín. Ahora quiero que me digan una oración en español, dos oraciones, una que se interrumpa. Por ejemplo, yo estaba cantando cuando sonó el teléfono. Mi hermano se estaba bañando cuando se fue la luz. Ya, siempre vamos a utilizar el cuando. ¿Ok? Entonces.
Estaba soñando cuando desperté.
Yep. No sé qué tipo de sueño es de Marie, but yes. So that's it. Ok. Vamos a ver, Andreita. Sean creativos, va. Aprovechen que estamos
en español. Estaba escuchando música cuando se fue la luz.
Yes. Algo copiona, pero está bien. Bien. Dianita, and then Charlie.
Yo me estaba bañando cuando se fue el agua.
Qué va. Bueno, espero que no hayas estado enjabonada, Anita. Charlie en Mercy.
Estaba dormido cuando tembló.
Ok. Y así dice Charlie, despiértame cuando pase el temblor. Mercy en Maritza.
Yo estaba comiendo cuando atendí una emergencia.
Perfecto. Maritza, Susi.
Estaba cocinando cuando sonó el timbre.
Yeah, Perfect. Susie, Jasmine.
Nosotros estábamos tomando café cuando llovió.
Café, ok. Thanks. Jasmine, Beatriz. Okay, let's move to Bea and then Edgar.
Estaba cocinando cuando se fue el gas.
Eso es triste. That's sad, okay. Edgar and Elsa.
Estaba durmiendo cuando tembló.
Okay, good. Elsa, Manuel.
Estaba lloviendo, perdón, estaba manejando cuando llovió.
Mm-hmm. Good. Manuel, Kevin.
Estaba durmiendo cuando me despertaron ya después.
Sorry for you. Yeah. Kevin. ¿Sabes qué soñabas? Kevin en Eden Nilsson.
Estaba soñando con ella cuando sonó la alarma.
Ya te van a regañar, Kevin. A vos sí te pueden dar las orejas, ¿verdad, Mercy? Que lo pueden regañar. Ok. Eden Nilsson en Helen.
Estaba durmiendo cuando llegó mi jefe.
Ok. Eso es triste, ok. Helen, are you there?
Iba para el trabajo cuando empezó a llover.
Ok. O la otra, estaba viendo Netflix cuando llegó mi jefe. Ok, so, if you notice, there is an action.
¿Le pasó a usted?
No, no, así dicen.
Ah.
Así dicen, Manuel. Normalmente con esto hay una acción que se está dando, pero hay otra que lo interrumpe. ¿Ok? So that's it. Eso quiero que tengan en cuenta. There's an action going on and there's another that interrupts. La que interrumpe es el pasado simple. Y la acción que se está dando es el pasado continuo. I was going, I was singing, I was working, she was watching TV, he was kissing best friend, or I don't know, lo que sea. Está pasando esa acción y la otra lo interrumpe, ¿ok? Ahora que ya tenemos, now we have clear this, repito. They were enjoying the morning, ellos estaban disfrutando la mañana, when the thief stole the briefcase, cuando el ladrón robó el maletín. Ahora, Susie, ¿qué acción pasó primero? ¿Disfrutando o el robo?
Disfrutando.
Estaban disfrutando. No sabemos cómo, pero estaban disfrutando. And then, le robaron el maletín. Poor of them, pobrecitos. Entonces, aquí va, ¿ve? Aquí va la, ¿cómo se llama? La acción. Y de repente, le robaron. Pero todo eso es en el pasado. Everything is in the past. Estamos hablando en el pasado. ¿Ok? Ahora, vamos con lo siguiente. Simple past versus past continuous. Completed action habits, facts, and past. Okay, I will need Charlie, please. I went.
I went to the cinema yesterday.
Thank you. Sencillo. Fui al cine ayer. Ya estuve en, ya, eso ya terminó, estuve en el pasado. Continue, Charlie.
I always visit my grandparents in my summer holidays when I was little.
Okay, continue. I live
near Liverpool for a couple of years.
Okay, eso es el pasado. Pasado, ya lo pasado, pasado, como dijo José José. Ahora aquí tenemos el pasado. Continue, past continue. Dianita, please. I was watching
TV when the phone rang. Last night.
Please continue.
Last night at 7 p.m., I was having dinner.
While
she was doing her homework, her brother was playing football.
Acciones que estaban pasando, ok. While significa mientras, por si no lo saben, pueden anotarlo, ok. Mientras, while, ok. Ahora vamos a la práctica, ok. Ok, vamos a ir a esta práctica. When you arrive, aquí solo está el pasado. Miren, pasado, 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 pasado. Ahora vamos a poner el past continuous, ¿ok? When you arrive at the party, Alan, ¿ok? Vamos a ver si me ayuda acá, Maritza. Past continuous, ¿cómo sería acá?
Alan danza.
Casi, no. Ok. Ajá. Alan. Pasado continuo. Alan.
Ah, excuse me. Alan was dancing.
Yes.
When you arrived at the park.
Ajá. Y puede ser así. When you arrived at the party, Alan was dancing. O Alan was dancing. Oh, when you arrived at the park. No, that's good, Maritza. Thank you. Cualquiera de las dos formas es correcta. Ok, perfect. Now let's go with Damari and then Charlie.
When you arrived at the party, Susie was drinking.
Ok. Susie was drinking. Imagínate, Susie. Ok.
Ya qué está casualidad del destino. No, sí, ya está escrito.
Ya está escrito. Ok. Thank you. Ok, now let's go with Andrea and then Mercy.
When you arrived at the party, was John and Anne singing?
John and Anne were
singing.
Si quieren pasa, Andreita, estás enamorada. Ok, thank you. Dianita and then Mercy.
Number six.
Mm-hmm.
When you arrived at the party, we was cooking.
We were cooking. Perfect. Okay, Diana and Susie.
Okay, and number seven. Jane was playing the guitar when you arrived at the party.
Okay. Así como Luis, puede ser de una manera o de otra. Ok, pueden cambiar. Perfect. Ok, let's go with Susie, right? Susie and Elsa.
Me gustan los retos, así que intentaré number 10. When you arrive at the party, everybody where?
Was.
Have fun. No.
Everybody was.
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 ¿Por qué? Was. How funny. Having fun.
Having fun. Yes. 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 Ahorita te lo voy a poner acá.
¿Por qué was, teacher?
Siempre que utilizan con everybody, is. Everybody.
In the Spanish, yo tomaría parts. Como ellos, todos ellos.
Sí, no. Everybody significa cada quien, cada uno. Pero nosotros lo traducimos como todos. Hey, everybody, let's go. ¿Verdad? Okay, everybody, put your hands up, y todo eso, ok. Pero everybody realmente significa cada quien o cada uno. Por eso cada uno está, ajá. Entonces.
Ahí ya no es plural. No. Gramáticamente escrito ya no es plural, ¿verdad?
No, people es plural. Y normalmente con people decimos people is, y es people are, porque son las personas. Pero con everybody, y eso sí, anótenlo. Everybody has, por ejemplo. Everybody has a right. Cada quien tiene su derecho. Cada quien tiene derecho. Ya. Entonces, así, everybody es singular. Cosas de la vida, ¿verdad? Bien extraño. Pero yo sé, yo lo sé. I understand you. Yo también estoy a favor de que everybody sea plural. Yo estoy a favor de eso. Y igual estoy a favor de que after signifique antes y no signifique después. También estoy a favor de eso. Ok. But that's English. Eso es parte del inglés. Ok. Ok. Now let's listen to Elsa, right? Elsa and then Beatriz.
Number 8. When you arrived at the party, Davey was reading a book.
Yes, reading a book. Perfect. Beatriz and Eden Nilsson.
Number 4.
Okay.
When you arrive at the party, Luke was talking to the girls.
Ajá, le está hablando a las chicas este Luke. Okay. Who's next? Who's next? Eden Nilsson and then Manuel.
Okay, let me see. Number five.
Five.
When you arrive at the party, Jody Jody was put yes. on makeup. Putting on makeup.
Thank you. And Manuel, number nine, when?
When you arrive at the party, Francis was sitting the corner.
Yes, perfect. Okay, thank you very much. Now, you know, ahora ya saben, ¿verdad? Simple past versus past continuous, okay? So, we already know this. Y ya lo saben también en inglés y en español, okay? So, have you ever had accidents at home? Tell an anecdote. In for this case, we're going to have Charlie, your turn.
My turn. Yes. I have
and,
the,
and then Eden Nilsson. You have many.
I isolated one, but when I say to my wife this activity, she remember one in particular. Several months ago, my wife has changed the accommodation in our room. And at night, my daughter wake up crying. I took me to the go and see what happened to him. And because of the shame my wife had made, she almost hit, no, she no sería me, me almost hit in the window.
Oh, okay.
I turned around and I ran in another direction and I crashed into the wall.
Okay.
It's very funny. But then I turned up, that Nicole, she had fallen, me had fallen in the bed. And when I tried to pick up her up, I feel too. When I turned on the light, we realized that I had been injured and hit me in the wall. Thank you. Thank God my daughter no longer wake up screaming, and my wife, whenever she is going to change the order of the room, she warms me 2 days before.
Yes, so you don't have any other accidents because you were accustomed. Estaba acostumbrado. You were accustomed to the to another order, right? So, but did you have any injury? Tuviste heridas?
Yes, in the head.
Forehead.
Yes. In the head, I sangrar.
Aha, bleed.
I bleed.
You were bleeding. Okay.
Yes, I bleeding much.
Okay, algo estabas pagando, Charlie. Creo que ese es el precio. That's the price.
La anécdota, dice Franco Camilla, así que.
Okay, anécdota. What about, who's next? Eden Nilsson.
Yes, a short time ago, I was an accident with Zoe. Yes, it was funny because I changed her disposable diaper, maybe, okay.
Yes.
Or pamper.
Pamper or diaper, yes.
Okay. Then I put on her bad.
Ah, bad. Okay.
Yes. Then a few minutes later, she do poppy.
Okay. Hey.
Uh-huh. And she ensució.
Yeah, screw.
Scrub
Crowds.
All mm-hmm. the the leggings that wow. he was wearing
okay.
at this in this moment, and my wife he was laughing so much when
okay,
watched
with that happened. So okay, but who cleaned that? ¿Quién limpió eso? You or your wife? Okay, come
no,
on.
My wife.
What's your fault? Tu culpa, fíjate. Okay. Yes, but I guess that was like a funny experience, but you learned about it. ¿Aprendiste de eso?
¿Verdad? Yes, yes.
You're not going to do it
sí,
again.
Yo pensaba bañarla de un solo, pero no me dejaron.
Okay. Well, you have to take into account that. Okay, so thank you. Yes, that usually happens when we don't do things in the correct form. That happens. Okay, and what if we go with Beatriz? Hello, Beatriz. Are you? You have your anecdote.
I remember 3 days ago. I think don't remember. I was in my bedroom and suddenly a cucaracha.
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 Yes. Roach o cockroach. Uh-huh.
Ah, okay. Eso. Eso es espantoso.
Beautiful.
And I know. And I have a. I don't know.
Okay.
No sé qué sentí, o fue horrible. Se empecé a gritar.
Ñañaras, okay. Yes. And did it fly? ¿Voló? No voló.
Ay, sí, horrible. Y entonces solo sentí que se me empezó a parar en el pelo. Y fue horrible, horrible.
Okay.
But I have a special, I don't know, how did I, como una... maña, costumbre, no sé cómo le podría llamar a eso. But when I'm scary, me pican las axilas.
Oh. Okay, Bea, I guess that's a response of your body. Tu cuerpo responde a eso, es una alerta.
I don't know, but es horrible. Entonces, mame, vas haciendo la sensación otra vez.
Ajá, tranquila, todavía no te rasques, tranquila, yes.
Es que estoy aquí sola y siento que me va a aparecer una.
No, hombre, qué tal. Ok, I guess.
Eso me parece.
Mira, Yasmín ya se está rascando. Ok, I guess nobody likes cockroaches. A nadie le gustan las cucarachas, I guess. Pero ustedes se comen las cucarachas de mar en cócteles, ¿verdad?
Son y son tan ricas.
Sí, son ricas, que son los camarones. Son cucarachas de mar, so they are very tasty, sabroso. Con una soda, ¿verdad? So, sí, con una soda bien helada.
O maybe a beer, teacher.
Oh, maybe, maybe a beer. Okay, so Bea, I'm so sorry for your experience, but how many times have you been scared by a cockroach? How many times?
Well, my life.
In your life? All your life, toda tu vida. Creo que ese es un es parte del karma, pobrecita la cucaracha.
Horrible, no, es lo peor.
Okay. Yes, I guess that when you see a cockroach and you want to kill him, cuando lo quieren matar, sometimes you are very silent, and then it jumps, y salta, and starts flying, and that's the worst thing. Esa es la parte. La
y lo peor es que nadie la quiso matar por mí. Entonces, como estaba haciendo un gran escándalo, nadie me quiso ayudar. Eso es lo peor.
Ok, I'm sorry. Sí, tenés que sobrevivir por ti mismo. Ok. Pobre cucarachita. Que descanse en paz. Ok, we continue with this and we go to the speaking. Here we have some synonyms. Tenemos algunos sinónimos similar to yesterday. Ok. We're going to start with Damari. Damari, yes, yes, yes. Es que vos siempre me oís, Damari. And then we go with Maritza.
teacher only read or choose the
answer? You have to read the sentence and then choose the answer.
Okay.
What number?
Number one.
The girls?
The girls were surprised when they saw the beautiful flowers. The delivery boy brought.
Brought, okay. Uh-huh. Brought. Beautiful, it's similar to?
Pretty.
Pretty. Pretty. Yes, pretty. Okay, perfect. Thank you. Maritza and then Edgar.
Number four.
Okay.
The
librarian.
Librarian asked the children to be silent because everyone was trying to study. Quiet.
Perfect, Maritza. Ahora, miren el ejemplo. Everyone, como everybody, similar. Ya ven que no les miento, vean, por la... Aquí está la verdad, ¿verdad? Everyone was singular, ¿verdad? Para que no me crean más de lo... Todos me tienen que creer, todos los...
Thank Pero you. Así vamos a seguir diciendo where.
No. Oh, come on, Susie. Who's next? Edgar. Yes, my friend. And then Helen.
Okay. Number three.
Yeah.
Jennifer roasted hot dog was raining when it fell into the fire.
Okay.
Letter A, flames.
Yes, flames. Yes, perfect. Thank you. Okay, Helen and then Jasmine.
Number two.
Mm-hmm.
Watching, ¿cómo se dice, teacher?
Watching, yeah, watching.
Watching the movie with all of my friends from school was good, but it was too long.
Mm-hmm. But it was too long. Mm-hmm. ¿Qué te dice tu corazón?
Short?
Mm-mm. Long is the opposite of short. Es lengthy. Okay? Lengthy. Okay, good. Who's next?
Me.
Jasmine. Okay, me and then Diana.
Number five.
Mm-hmm.
My grandpa made the new dollhouse complete with miniature
furniture
for every room. Mm-hmm. Letter B, tiny.
Yes, tiny. Yes, that's good. Perfect. Okay, and here we have also, who's next? Diana. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Number seven. Mr. Blackwell
assigned
a difficult project for the students to complete during their vacation. Letter D, hard.
Yes, perfect. Okay, Andrea, are you there? And then Charlie.
Number six.
Okay.
The boys on the soccer team were hungry after the game, so they went to eat pizza. Mm-hmm. Is starving.
Yes, starving. Cuando ustedes dicen, I'm starving, me estoy muriendo de hambre. Starving significa cuando ustedes están, pero súper hambrientos. Okay. Charlie, number eight. The college professor.
The college professor was white and... Gave the new student a lot of good advice. Is intelligent.
Intelligent, okay. Wise es sabio, so like similar to intelligent. Okay, perfect. Thanks for your answers. Now let's go to the listening part. Here we have a girl's voice. Okay, tenemos la voz de una chica en esta ocasión. Okay, be ready with your pen or pencil. Let's go.
My favorite restaurant. Oh, let us have salad. It's not really a restaurant, more a salad bar, but you can get pasta and that type of thing too. They have about 100 varieties of salad, but I have my two or three favorites. Lemon chicken salad, Turkish couscous salad, and the one which the owner recommended to me, Russian caviar salad. A bit expensive, but worth every penny. Actually, I know the owner quite well, as we've worked together in the past. So I can eat very healthy and have a chat at the same time. I probably go there once a week at least.
Okay, listen again.
My favorite restaurant. Oh, let us have salad. It's not really a restaurant, more a salad bar, but you can get pasta and that type of thing too. They have about 100 varieties of salad, but I have my two or three favorites, lemon chicken salad, Turkish couscous salad, and the one which the owner recommended to me, Russian caviar salad. A bit expensive, but worth every penny. Actually, I know the owner quite well, as we've worked together in the past. So I can eat very healthy and have a chat at the same time. I probably go there once a week at least.
Okay, I guess this audio was very slow. Creo que estaba un poco lento este audio, but well, and that's good as well. Jasmine, what did you get from this audio?
I can eat very healthy.
Mm-hmm. That's perfect. Mercy, and then Damari.
My favorite restaurant of there, no sé si decía. Three favorite, lemon, chicken. Otro sí no lo entendí.
Okay.
Okay,
thank you. Damari and Charlie.
I have three favorite lemon chicken salad.
Okay, good, Damari. Charlie, Diana.
You can eat the pasta and Russian caviar salad.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that's it. Good. Diana, Maritza.
They have a more a salad bar. I probably once a week at least.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Maritza, Andrea.
So I can eat very healthy. It's not really a restaurant.
Mm, it's not really a restaurant, they say. Okay, Andrea, and we go with Manuel.
Salad bar, but you can get pasta.
Salad bar, said Manuel and Susie.
Okay, my favorite restaurant, pasta, salad, recommended to me, entre otras.
Okay, thank you. Susie?
The say of my colleagues, actually I know the other.
Okay, thank you. And let's listen again. Here we have this. Okay. Let's listen again.
My favorite restaurant. Oh, let us have salad. It's not really a restaurant, more a salad bar. But you can get pasta and that type of thing too. They have about 100 varieties of salad. But I have my two or three favorites. Lemon chicken salad, Turkish couscous salad, and the one which the owner recommended to me, Russian caviar salad. A bit expensive, but worth every penny. Actually, I know the owner quite well, as we've worked together in the past. So I can eat very healthy and have a chat at the same time. I probably go there once a week at least.
Okay, and so here, maybe part of the vocabulary, here we have a penny. Cuando decimos, but worth, si quieren anoten esa palabra, worth significa vale la pena, algo valioso. Por eso cuando Thor dice, I'm worthy, ¿verdad? Cuando él levanta el Mjolnir, dice, soy, ¿cómo dice?
Digno.
Soy digno. Yes, 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 soy digno. Thank you. Soy digno, o sea, valioso todavía. Entonces, worth significa valioso o si vale la pena. Eso significa worth. ¿Mm? Por ejemplo, it worth it. Por ejemplo, eso lo vale, ¿ok? Or saving, saving money, worth it, ¿verdad? Vale la pena guardar dinero, ahorrar dinero. Por eso dice, but worth every penny, pero vale cada centavo. Penny significa centavito, ¿ok? And that's it, okay? So part of some of this vocabulary. So, that's it. So, have you ever had accidents at home? Tell an anecdote. 29 minutes and we finish. 29 minutos y terminamos. And we're going with Andrea. Andreita, and then we go with Diana.
Okay. I don't have any accident, but once my nephew was flying in the sofa, my mom is regañar teacher, is called.
Mm-hmm. It's called.
It's called him, but he ignored. Then he fell and hurt his how? Mm-hmm. Acá, esta parte de acá.
Joe.
Se abrió.
Joe.
Ah. Ajá, Joe.
Ajá.
Mm-hmm. Y tuvieron que coserlo.
Similar to one of my cousins. He was jumping from one sofa to another sofa. And my aunt says, don't do it, please. Be careful. Mm-hmm. But he didn't take care. So he fell down and the Joe, la quijada, la mandíbula.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So he has another mouth. Tiene otra boquita ahí.
Sí.
Okay, that's it. Actually, the movie of Tiburón, it calls Jaws. La película de Tiburón se llama Jaws, ¿verdad? O sea, mandíbula. Quijada, ajá. No es que se llame Tiburón. La película es a la viejita. So, that's it. Okay, so that happens because don't follow orders or instructions. Okay, thanks. Dianita, and after Diana, we're going with Elsa.
Okay, once I fell in the shower because going barefoot to the bathroom was not serious, but it scared me.
Okay, did you hurt? ¿Te lastimaste?
Solo moretones.
Where? In the back, in the espalda, in the arm, or in another
the
part?
Leg. Uh-huh.
Okay.
En las piernas.
En las piernas. Nada más. Okay. The legs. Okay. Okay. I'm sorry for you, but that's better than the head. Es mejor ahí que en la cabeza. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Dianita. And Elsa, please.
Yes. In the garden,
curing a plant, pero en realidad quería decir enredadera, pero no sé cómo se dice.
Ok, yes, podría ser scaling plants, son las que se enredan, las que suben, ¿verdad?
Todas. Yes.
Son
aéreas. It's a rollet in my hand. O sea, yo la estaba jalando y cortando, pero la enredé en la mano y se me quedó trabada en un dedo. Depression with my great in pain. El dolor era súper grande, no llevaba qué hacer. Entonces tuve que ir al doctor porque sí se me hinchó el dedo. Mm-hmm. Y la no lo podía cortar.
Okay. Okay, but nothing more about it. I mean, nothing serious. Nada serio.
No, nada serio.
Okay.
No serio.
Okay, thanks. Thanks for sharing, and it is important to take care about it, to be careful.
Sí, yo siempre ocupo guantes.
Yes, why not? And even there are thorns, a veces hay espinas.
Mm-hmm.
There are thorns at home. We in the garden we have some roses, and my mother says that we have to cut it. And yeah, you can get hurt. Puedes lastimarte con las espinitas.
No, y ahora tengo cactus en el jardín y no se siente hasta que se pasa la mano una hijo ahí está molestando.
Hay una molestia, incomodidad. Yes.
¿Cómo se dice espinita? Una espina en
Thorn no sé es espina en general. Thorn.
Ah, okay.
Can be a little thorn o cactus thorn, que son espinas todavía. Mm-hmm. Okay. Thanks. Here we go to. Bien, ya que vimos esta parte. Past continuous. Después vamos con el future continuous. And Eden Nilsson, are you ready with your song? What's the name of this song?
Yes, I'm ready.
Go ahead, my friend. Your turn.
Give a second.
Problem. Take your time.
This is the letter.
Okay, very nice picture. Mm-hmm.
And
can you read it? No, I mean first read all the paragraph. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Trust I seek and I find in you every day for us something new, open mind for a different view, and nothing else matters.
I know what song it is.
The Pink Floyd.
No,
it's Metallica. Oh.
Yes.
Yes, it's
nothing else matters.
Yes.
Yes.
Nothing else matters.
Pero la que canta con Miley Cyrus no me gusta.
No. Pregúntale a Marlon si le gusta. Okay, no está Marlon acá. But yes, okay. So, y esa es la misma, creo que that's the same song that they share with Miley Cyrus. Okay, yes, and Nothing Else Matters from the Black Album. Okay, Ede, go ahead with the
pronoun. This is a pronoun. Pronoun, verb, pronoun.
Okay, verb. Fine. Is it regular or irregular?
It's a regular.
It's irregular. Irregular.
Mm-hmm. Ah, yes. Found. Found.
Yes, is found. Mm-hmm. That's past.
Okay. Adverb of frequency.
Yes. Yes. Every day.
This is a adjective.
Adjective, perfect.
Pronoun.
Object pronoun. Yes, us. Mm-hmm. For us.
Verb. Regular verb.
Regular verb.
Maybe adjective.
Adjective. Yes, it is.
Only.
Yes, that's it. Okay, perfect. And thank you, Edenilson. A very nice song. I really like this song. And you are right, related to the parts of the speech. So thank you, Eden Nilsson. And for tomorrow, we have, let's see, who's...
Tomorrow.
I'm sorry, Monday. No sé por qué siempre los viernes les digo mañana. Siempre, I don't know why. Imagino que voy a ir a misa con ustedes, maybe. Okay. Edgar. Edgar for Monday. Okay.
Edgar. Yes, teacher.
Okay, thanks. And 21 minutes, 21 minutos, y terminamos. Let's go to the conversations part. Okay. I'm going to send you the conversations in this order, please. Here we have three conversations. That's number one. Number two, and finally, okay, I'm going to create the pairs. Voy a crear los equipos. Take a look. Dale una revisada ahorita. Dale una revisada. Conversations. Okay, first of all, vamos a dar una pequeña revisada. Reporting wrong charges, always related to payment, relacionado al pago. Entonces, reportando cargos equivocados. Okay, so here we have the first one. What can I do for you today? I have an issue. Tengo un problema. Issue is dificultad, problema. What is your problem? There were charges on my debit card that I never made. Do you have a statement for your debit card? I do. Which charges are you talking about? It's the last four charges. We're going to have the, we're going to do, aquí creo que, pues se me equivocaron. We're going to do an investigation. Okay. Is that going to take long? I'm not sure, but in the meantime, we will freeze this charge. That's wonderful. Thank you. And here we have, may I help you? I'm having a problem. What a problem are you having? There have been charges made on my debit card that I didn't make. Do you have the statement for your card? Here it is. What are the charges you're referring to? The last four charges on the page. I'm afraid we're going to investigate these charges. How long will I investigate? How long will an investigation take? I honestly don't know, but we will freeze payment on these charges. That sounds absolutely fantastic. Todas las palabras las conocen, all the words you know them. And the last one, may I help you? I have a problem. What's the problem? Someone else is making charges on my debit card. I need to see a statement for your debit card. I have it right here. Can you show me which charges you're referring to? The last four charges. We will need to do an investigation on this. How long will that take? We'll have to freeze payment on those charges until the investigation is finished. I really appreciate your help. Cuando decimos statement es el estado de cuenta. Statement. Es un estado de cuenta que normalmente nos hacen con las con cualquier pues, tipo de movimiento de cuenta o de tarjeta. Okay, we're going to practice 5 minutes. Try to practice the 3 conversations and see you in a couple of seconds.
Esa era la primera.
Primera. How may I help you?
I'm having a problem. To investigate these chairs.
How long would that investigation take?
I honestly don't know, but we will freeze payment on this charge.
That sounds absolutely fantastic.
Okay, la siguiente.
Wait.
Okay.
May I help you?
I have a problem.
What's the problem?
Someone else is making chairs on my debit card.
I need to see a statement for your debit card.
I am afraid we're going to investigate this charge.
How long will an investigation take?
I honestly don't know, but with praise payment on.
Ahí está.
La segunda.
Sí, oye, sí. Vamos con la segunda, ¿verdad? Sí.
Me da risa cómo se ponen serias de repente. Ajá, como que de repente.
Teacher.
No le creo muchito esa seriedad.
Teacher, please. Solo era un pequeñito paréntesis.
No, está bien. Miren, una pregunta. ¿Usted ya se conocía?
No.
No, nada.
No, primera vez entramos.
¿Por qué?
No, curiosidad.
Solo le estaba recetando unas inyecciones para que se inyecte, porque solo está durmiendo 4 horas, dicen. Entonces no es suficiente. Bueno,
no, de verdad. ¿Cuánto es suficiente, Mercy?
8 horas, 8 lo mínimo.
Yo no duro. No duro. 7, no duermo.
7 es lo máximo.
Yo 6 duermo. ¿Y cuáles son las inyecciones, Mercy? Sí, sí, como 6 horas duermo yo.
Yo le estaba diciendo a ella que compro unas que se llaman Neuralin. Lleva las vitaminas B12, vitaminas neurotropas. Y lleva para el dolor porque dice que le duele la parte de acá.
Todo eso me duele. Si cuando me dé que esté así.
Es porque ya no aguanto el dolor de la espalda.
Sí, necesito inyectar.
Pero ese es el estrés. Sí, vaya, mira, a ver si te receta eso. Susi, pregúntale qué te receta. Te receta otra cosa acá.
Sí, no. Tiene que inyectarse. Mejor no, inyectado.
Bueno.
Sí. Ay, vamos, no, ¿en la que íbamos?
Ah, oíla. No les vaya, creo nada, vaya, ya me voy.
Rapidito.
Sigan, sigan.
Payment on those charges until the investigation is finished.
I really appreciate your help.
Hello, Manuel. Are you there? ¿Estás por ahí, Manuelito?
Hey, hello, teacher.
Estás un poco triste. No te pongas triste, hombre, Manuel. Tranquilo, tranquilo.
¿Por qué?
¿Estás un poco ocupado con lo de Excel?
No, no. Los viernes no hay clases.
Va, chévere. Practiquemos ahorita la conversación 1. ¿Qué te lo voy a poner?
Okay.
Dale, vos comenzás. O yo comienzo. What can I do for you today?
I have an
issue.
Okay.
What is your problem?
There were charges on my debit card that I never made.
And do you have a statement for your debit card?
I do.
Which charges are you talking about?
It's the last 4 charges.
We're going to have to do an investigation.
Is that going to take long?
I'm not sure, but in the meantime, we will freeze discharge.
That's wonderful. Thank you.
Okay, let's go with number 2. How may I help you?
I'm having a problem.
What problem are you having?
There have been charged on my debit card that I didn't make.
Do you have the statement for your card?
It is.
What are the charges you're referring to?
The last 4 chairs on the page.
I'm afraid we're going to investigate this charge.
How long will an investigation take?
Honestly, I don't know, but we will freeze payment on these charges.
That sounds absolutely sub. Absolutely,
sounds.
Sounds bad.
Sounds. Absolutely. It's fantastic.
It's fantastic.
Okay, perfect. Bien. Vamos a ver los demás. Ya vienen, ya me vinieron estas dos chicas que tenemos acá.
Don teacher, ¿y cómo se pronuncia cargos? ¿Chairs o
charge?
Okay.
Charge. Ah, Susi, ¿cómo te estás portando, mujer?
Excelente, como siempre.
¿Segura?
Sí, totalmente, al 100%.
Okay. So, let's listen to... Ya vamos a terminar. Manuel, can you say your anecdote? ¿Tuvo un accidente, Manuel? Any accident?
Yeah. When I was a child, I have 5 or 6 years old, I fell a maca.
Uh-huh.
Heart, man, my heart, and my head.
Ajá.
Elon, aún tengo la marca, un centímetro y medio, pero pegué en el filo, estaba una plancha de atrás, porque no extendí la maca, sino que como que solo la hice como rollito y solo para sentarme, y en lo que iba a agarrar el envión, me fui para atrás.
¿Qué?
Pero no dolió la caída, sino la gran talegada.
Yes. That's the cure, es la cura, ¿verdad?
Siempre sí, cuando ando haciendo esas cosas.
Thank you, Manuel. Ok, solo quiero hacer un paréntesis y me alegra ver cómo todos trabajan con las conversations cuando están en los en las sesiones, los breakout rooms. Me gusta pasar y ver que ustedes están tan concentradas en la práctica del inglés. Les felicito. Y también hay otras que disimulan cuando yo llego ahí. Y como, ahí viene el teacher, viene el teacher. Entonces,
sigamos.
Ajá, cabal. Y cuando yo me voy, ajá, pues sí, ¿en qué estábamos? Ajá. Ya me imagino. No sé. I'm just saying. No, but it's good. I like that you are having like a very nice environment, very good friendship. Me gusta que se lleven bastante bien. Todos ustedes son bien amigables. Algunos un poquito comunicativos y son bien sociales, but very good people. Son geniales, son buenas personas. Okay, we're about to finish. Damari.
Present.
No, tranquila.
Goodbye.
No, ve. No, the anecdote. Ya me lo dijiste, la anecdote. Si te ibas a disparar, ¿verdad? Dale, go ahead.
Teacher, I have many anecdotes. But...
Just one?
Yes, but yesterday I have algo chistoso.
Something funny.
Yes, teacher. I fell from the chair because when I sit down, sería
when I sat.
Yes, when I sat. The chair broke y me caí y me golpeé el pie.
You fell down, se quebró la silla.
Se quebró la silla de plástico, entonces no para, o sea, no sentí el dolor por reírme.
Okay, I'm sorry, but creo que ya estaba quebradita la silla, creo.
Teacher, I don't know, so del ruido fue grande, como si un estruendo.
De verdad. Y vos sentadita, ¿sí? Ok, me imagino.
Me golpeé fuerte.
Algo estás pagando, don. Algo.
No. No le conté a Mercy para que me diera algo.
Ya te va a dar una. Te va a recetar la medicina por ahí. Ok, thank you, Damari. And we go with Helen. Are you ready, Helen?
Hello, teacher.
Ready with your anecdote? Any accident?
I have not any serious accident at home.
Okay, no serious accidents at home. So no problem with that. Okay, thank you. And what if we go with Kevin? Kevin?
Hello, teacher.
Any accident at home?
Yes, only one.
Okay.
Was when they were remodeling the house. We raise a piece of what you could with the polisher and it brushed my leg. Then I made a deep one and now I have a very ugly scar in my leg.
Really? A big, big scar?
Deep.
Deep scar. Okay, I'm so sorry.
Deep.
Sí, te quedó una cicatriz. Well, I'm so sorry. Yes, that's dangerous even. But now you're okay. O sea que ya no puedes ser modelo, Kevin. I'm sorry for you.
De hecho, lo sigo haciendo.
Oh, okay, that's perfect. That's good. Thank you. Sigo haciendo. Jasmine, are you ready? We're going to finish.
I don't know that right now.
Okay. No problem. Take your time. I'm going to check the attendance list. No problem, Jasmine. I'm going to check the attendance list and we say goodbye. Today we have, yes, Eden Nilsson, the 10-minute session, okay? Ana Mercedes, hello.
Hi.
Hi, Andrea.
I'm here.
There, Charlie.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Let's see, Maritza.
Present.
Thank you, Diana.
See you later.
Eden Nilsson. Yes.
I'm here.
Thank you, Edgar.
Hey, good night.
Hi, Elsa.
Present, teacher.
Thanks. Damari.
Happy weekend.
La de la silla. Okay, Helen.
Present teacher.
Kevin. Modelo.
I'm here teacher.
Well, thanks. El de la maca.
Okay. No, me se ve mal esto.
Okay.
Ojalá no present. Le pase, oiga.
¿Qué pasó?
Ojalá no se le quiebre la silla a usted nunca.
Dios mediante, no. Mira lo que me estás diciendo, ma. Okay. Susie Q.
Bye bye.
Bye bye. And Jasmine, que está ocupadita. En Beatriz.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Okay, my friends, see you on Monday. Have I'm a good here. Weekend. Thank you. Thank you.
Good night.
Descansen.
Descansen. Bye, teacher.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, Nelson, we have a couple of minutes. Tenemos un par de minutos. ¿Habrá algo que te gustaría que reforzáramos? Maybe conversation, any grammar structure, alguna estructura gramatical, algún tema que hemos visto en clase? Anything that maybe you want to talk about? Hello, no te puedo escuchar. I can't hear you.
I'm sorry, my microphone was off.
Was off, okay.
At the class, I think that I understand so-so.
Mm-hmm.
But with the homeworks, in the middle exam, yes, middle exam.
Uh-huh.
In the last part, the first two questions,
mm-hmm.
I try to do the different forms and
no X. No. Okay.
I remember that. It about me da las palabras and I have to try to order
to order the sentences.
Yes.
Do you have the screenshot? ¿Tienes la captura de pantalla?
Let me see.
You can send it to me by WhatsApp. Si gusta puede mandármelas por WhatsApp porque no las podemos mostrar por acá.
Okay. Here is, but the thing that is very difficult for me,
okay,
it they use the prepositions.
Ah, prepositions, okay.
But more the time.
Mm-hmm.
Of, in, at.
Okay, if you have it, you can send it to me.
Right now, here is. Ahorita lo estoy adjuntando. The listening that today was more easy than the last days.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, I will change to. Mm-hmm. And you have tried in different forms.
Yes.
Have you tried with the period? ¿Has intentado con un punto al final?
Yes.
And low caps, minúsculas también, todas minúsculas.
No. Mm-hmm. The pronoun put in capital.
Capital. Yes. Can you do it right now? Can you? No. Oh, this is a screenshot from yesterday.
Yes. No, but I have opened the webpage.
Okay, what about if you do it but with low caps, minúsculas, with pronoun? Okay. Try one.
Give me a second. Wait. Enviar. No.
Mm-hmm. We wouldn't like to stay in this place, right?
We wouldn't like to stay in this place, yes.
No.
No.
Y ya te fijaste que no le estás dando doble espacio. No hay doble espacio, ¿verdad? Entre las palabras.
No. No.
Ah, ya sé. La apóstrofe que le estás poniendo es la correcta. Porque hay diferentes. Ajá, ya te voy a explicar. Esta apóstrofe, la que te acabo de mandar en WhatsApp. Y esta otra que está algo rara, ¿sí? ¿Ya te fijas? Proba con la apóstrofe que es cabal, así, lineal, que es vertical.
That is... In the first one?
Esa sí se pudo.
No.
No, tampoco se pudo con la otra apóstrofe, así, lineal.
No.
Ok. Bien, ¿sabes qué?
The first one or the second one?
The second one.
Ok, va, voy a probar. Así lo tengo ahorita y le va la foto del apóstrofe.
Uh-huh.
Voy a probar con el otro, con ese que me envió usted. No, tampoco lo agarra. El que es como pando.
Pero qué raro. ¿Sabes qué? Vamos a ver esto tal vez mañana en la mañana. Hoy sé porque me parece bien extraño. Pero because your sentences are correct. Tus oraciones están correctas. Pero posiblemente hay algún detalle allí. Y me parece raro, fíjate en eso. Pero si no te has dado cuenta.
Voy a enviarle voy a enviarle ahorita una, quiero ver si puedo hacerlo ahorita así en la, como estamos. Voy a tratar de grabar la pantalla. Sí, me deja grabar. Vale, para que vea cómo la tengo completa la oración.
O copiarla y la pegas en el chat de WhatsApp. Quiero.
Ah, también.
Sí, ahorita.
Vaya, está así. Esta es la primera. Y probé incluso poner después de project el to.
Ajá, pero en el primero, en la que me acaban de mandar, I wouldn't, sería negativa, ¿verdad? Ah, no. I would change. No,
es positivo. Bueno, según lo que nos aparece en el enunciado, Así es positiva. La segunda es la negativa, esta que sí, voy a hacer ahorita.
Vaya, vamos a hacer algo, Ede. Probar la que te acabo de enviar, porque esa tiene otro tipo de apóstrofe. Copiar la que te acabo de enviar.
Que esa es como la tenía al principio.
Ajá. Y nada, ¿verdad?
No, ahorita la voy a probar otra vez. La voy a, así, tal cual me la envió, la voy a pegar acá. Nada, me sigue dando error.
Siempre error. Bye. No, vamos a hacer algo. Voy a revisar y mañana en la mañana voy a ver si te aviso, ¿ok? Porque me parece bien extraño, pero sí, la plataforma tiene a veces esas dificultades. ¿Ya te has dado cuenta, verdad? Que sí tiene esas pequeñas dificultades.
Sí, porque igual en el módulo anterior, en la actividad 17, no, en el módulo 2 fue, en el 1, ¿quiero ver? No, en el 2. En la actividad 17, en la tarea 17, igual había un error que con un pronombre era. Uh-huh. Que no lo agarraba en mayúsculas, sino que en minúsculas.
Bien raro, sí, sí. Sí, ya hemos tenido un par de comentarios con respecto a eso, pero igual, voy a revisar, Ede, ¿verdad? Y te aviso mañana porque ya se nos acabó el tiempo, pero gracias por decirme eso y voy a estar pendiente de esas, ¿ok? Porque vas un poco adelantado y eso es bueno. ¿Ok? ¿Verdad? Así que pues, un gusto de cualquier cosa y si no me escribes, ahí estamos pendientes, ¿ok?
Muchas gracias, muy amable.
Gracias a ti. Semana. Igualmente, bye bye.